Yes.
And what is that?
Making a band.
So that brings your life meaning.
Yes. I'll say so, yes.
How?
Well, who knows where we're gonna go?
Do we have to go anywhere?
No. And that's the best part. We just do what we want. We be ourselves, as you said.
So apart from the band, you weren't being yourself?
Sometimes.
You don't know if you're happy or not.
You're an hour late. If Max wasn't here with this band, we would have been fired. You keep screwing things up for us.
Look. What are you gonna do about it, Eliza?
J-Man.
Whatever. Something came up, alright? You know how my mom is. Anyways, just get ready for this show and we'll talk about it later or something. Okay.
Well, you're not gonna make it if you're late to every single start of our show.
Sure, yeah. Where do you want to go?
Anywhere but here. I gotta clear my head, you know?
Right.
Okay, let's go.
It really goes away.
Yeah, I have no more hair right there.
that candle thing, you like put your hand over the top of the candle and you see who can hold your hand on it the longest until the candle goes out. Have you ever done that? Oh.
That sounds insane.
It like burns so bad.
But
I win every time.
We're not ready. I'd rather not burn myself physically in there for like an hour and a half scrubbing everything.
Oh my God.
With water dripping from the ceilings and soaking wet. Yeah, it's not fun. I'd rather do the outsides. The outside's pretty cool.
Oh my gosh, that's so good. Look.
So what Jesus did is told her, take me to his tomb.
And
my wife is going to share a scripture with you guys.
It's in John chapter 11, verses 43 and 44. When he had said this, Jesus called in a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out." The dead man came out, his hands and feet wrapped in strips of linen and a cloth around his face. Jesus said to them, "Take off your grave clothes and let him go."
After hearing that scripture, what does it mean to you guys?
Well, what I think about it is it's pretty crazy because, like, he was dead for 4 days. And then, like, everybody was, like, devastated and stuff.
Everybody was.
And then, like,
God tests everybody in. And no matter what the test is, no matter what the thing you're going through
is. I thought it was pretty crazy.
There's always going to be a light at the end of the tunnel.
You know, Jesus pretty much brought a dead man to life, but... You know, with him, like he says he was only sleeping. So to me, it's just like I guess you could say it's what seemed dead wasn't really dead. It was just like how he said he was sleeping. So all he had to do was just wake him back up. So to me, it's kind of like, I don't know, sometimes I guess spiritually we seem like we're dead, but it's really only God who has that power to really revive us. That's what I got out of it.
And Jesus is calling us out like he calls out Lazarus. And maybe some of us, we've been dead for days. And it's time for us to let Jesus wake us up and let him take us out of that tomb. You know, after hearing the scripture, one word stood out to me is the word wake. And what does that word mean? It means get up, renewed, reignite, and also funeral. Funeral stood out to me as well. It reminds me of an old man's funeral. He was put to death so that I, a new man, could live through Christ. I remember when I was that old man running the street, doing what I wanted to do without a care. God came and woke me up, and here I am just living a Christ life. We're all friends of God, and he loves us so much that sometimes he let us die so that he can wake us up and he can get the glory out of it. I know that some of you guys may be struggling with something tonight.
And I do not want that around Jesus.
Being taken out of the hospital because of your drinking and pill. That's okay.
Yeah.
If you want me to move out or something, just tell me, all right?
That's not what I'm saying. I'm not saying that at all. I never said move out.
And I just want you guys to know that Jesus loves you and he can help. You might not want to share this in front of everybody, but let Jesus know. Let Jesus in your life. And we're going to come to a close right now, and my wife is going to lead us in prayer.
We could just all bow our heads and close our eyes, please.
God, we thank you for this day, Lord, and I just pray right now, God, that everything that was spoken here tonight, Lord, that it would penetrate into our hearts, God. And I pray, Father, that you would awaken that spirit within us, my God, that you would get rid of the old man, get rid of those bondages and those chains, my God, that are holding us back here today, God. I pray, Father, that from this day forward, that they would be a new person, my God, that they would be everything that you created them to be, my God, that hope, that
I wondered why they did that. forth. It's like, it means so much to them. Like, what they're doing really matters.
So they don't fall off.
Yeah, but they always do. I mean, seriously, it's so pointless. I mean, look, they spend all that time fixing their boards, and then, bam, a wave comes and wipe out.
So how much did you get?
It only allowed me to take out 200.
Down out for me. Palms together, like you're praying, interlace your fingers. Walk over here. So what are you guys doing out here? And what are you doing with this guy? This guy has nothing going for him right now. I work this area and I don't know you. Do your parents even know you're out here? They probably don't. Go ahead and hang tight for a second. You're lucky you came into contact with me than somebody in the neighborhood. People take advantage of you, especially her. I'm gonna go ahead and cut you a break today, but next time I see you, you're going to jail, she's going to jail, and you're gonna lose your car. Get yourself together. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Hi, how you doing? Hey, Jay, how's it going?
Hey, Mike. I'm doing good. How are you?
Been doing any surfing lately?
I haven't been able to make it out that way, you know.
How's the band going? Still singing?
We've been doing good for ourselves, you know. A couple of gigs here and there.
How's mom? She still working?
Mom working, huh? Yeah, she's whatever, man, you know.
Doing all right, bro. You don't look too good.
Look, I gotta go.
All right, brother. Take it easy.
You got it, right?
Yes, I got everything you wanted.
You didn't just get a bunch of crap.
I got everything you wanted. Where are we going now?
Jeez. I don't want this for you. What are you doing?
What, Mom? What don't you want from me?
I don't want this for you. I want you to be happy, son. Maybe you can go to rehab.
Yeah, like we have money for rehab.
I want you to have a happy life.
Truly?
Yes. I want more for you. I want more than this.
This is all I have. This is my life. Even if I wanted help, there is nobody. There is no one that can help me. And yet you want more. I wanted to see how much I could get for this.
It's in that other bag.
go, boy, get the bags, boy, let's go! Lucky you don't get smoked! Lucky! Get out of here!
While we're out here, though, just gotta be careful, okay? I want you to dive under the waves. Be in control of your mind. It's hard. It's hard to let go. So why when you're going out there, what ends up happening is you react and you don't act. I want you to act every time. If you think a wave's too big and you can't handle it, I want you to dive to the bottom and go underneath it. Don't try to go through it. Don't try to go over it. Just let go of the board. You have a leash on. You're not going to look down. You're not going to think about anything. What are you going to think about? Just that ride, shredding the gnar. Jesus, as we hit this water, please watch over us and please guide us. Please make sure we don't get hurt and come back safely. Through your name we pray. Amen. All right? That's all it's about, bro. Let's be safe while we're out there. So let's go take this whole shot. Let's go get these big waves out here. There's about 5 or 6 off the reef off here. We'll get barreled today. Let's go get barreled.
Lazarus, come out. The dead man came out, his hands and feet wrapped with strips of linen, and a cloth around his face. Jesus said to them, take off his grave clothes and let him go.
Well, after hearing his scripture, how do you guys feel?
I'm such a man. I feel like I'm broken into a million pieces. God, I can't do this anymore. I can't do this anymore. Can I talk to Nick? Yeah, it's Jay. I used to go to the Bible study there. Yeah, okay.
church I go to, they have a men's home. And I can get in contact with the home directors and get you in as soon as possible. Now in the home, that's where a lot of people get delivered. And I know that God has a plan for you, and you don't have to keep wandering in the streets anymore. We'll put you in a home, and we can get you help as soon as possible.
You got God's word to stand on. You got prayer to keep you to stand on that word. But if you slip off, you got the Holy Spirit, which is the Spirit of God that keeps you connected. And even if you slip a little bit, you can still get back on. Hello, somebody. And so that's the greatness of God. So today, know that God's word, you can stand on it. Through prayer, you can stand. And if you find in life, like I found in life, at times I've slipped off a little bit of where God wants me to be. Well, His Spirit is pursuing me to bring me back, woo, onto His Word, in the right connection with Him, and my life filled with joy, power, and love like it's meant to be. So give God praise for that. He's in the midst. God's creation, and we're going to enjoy it today on our boards. And let's go ahead and bow our heads, and we're just going to pray right now. Lord, we come before You. We thank You for this day and bringing us all together. And God, Lord, there's no coincidences when You're in the mix. And we just thank You that we're able to come and enjoy the gift of Your love and Lord, just Your presence. And I pray safety, protection, and Lord, just bless this time. In the name of Jesus, amen.